of women have not come to the place to understand that the sexual needs of a man is different from the sexual needs of a woman. Yes, a man works with visuals, what he sees. A woman works with hearing and touching. So you move a woman by what you tell her, how you touch her. But a man doesn't need to be touched. Once he sees, he acts. That means that how you dress can affect your marriage. How you appear affects your marriage, because you are not the only woman. That is why, remember, I told one foolish woman that he said he would dress so nice that the husband will not look at after any woman. I said that is good, but it can so based on that, because your beauty doesn't make another woman ugly. The fact that you are beautiful does not mean every woman is ugly. Do not deprive each other of sexual relationship unless you both agree to refrain from sexual intimacy. Both agree. Pregnancy should not be excuse why you deny your husband of sex. You are the one that is pregnant. I'm not the one. Oh, I'm going to hit things that will settle every controversy. No, defraud ye not one another, except it be with consent for a time, that you may give yourself to what? Fasting and prayer. And correcting. Me explaining your matter. And the reason I'm saying that is that you can marry a man that is unbeliever. You are a Christian, but your husband is not. So asking permission can be very difficult. And that one will not break your fasting. It will not affect you, because you are not the one giving the energy. As of you take a man, and say to him, they were very important. Between me and mommy, maybe mommy can ask permission from me. Oh, I want to do some fasting for 1 week. Because of my spiritual understanding, I will understand. And no cry no sumi yenipa. It depends on what is happening at what time. And chechemu di ehu hiyo. Because one take babu nini chechemu nasia. The trouble nini nai a lack of chechemu. A man will naturally lose appetite. And look at your money now. Be all about 10 days, not about 10 days, or about 5, not about 5. But naturally, you lose appetite. From my personal experience, you will lose appetite for it. The sex appetite, the greed at the convert, they will be lifted. But I'm saying this. Paul said, give permission. This is what Paul said, that defraud ye not one another. I said, be concerned. Well, so when we come back to the New Living Translation, look at the way he put it. He said, do not deprive each other of sexual relationship. Don't do it unless you both agree. Both. It means that it's both. If one has not agreed, agreement has not worked. In fact, there is no agreement at all. So all this depends on the kind of man you have married. Unless you both agree to refrain, both of you have agreed to refrain, not one person decided to refrain.
Yes, sir. Both.
Sometimes, some of you have used the fasting to deal with your matrimonial home. You declare fasting, but no cool start, you know, through. Acquires uncle for 70 days, you have a beer. Do you know somebody, his wife stopped her from coming to this church? Because the girl used the fasting as a weapon to deny the man of sex. And it comes back as if me namaka se. When the case came for me to settle it, it appears like you told them that when they are fasting, they shouldn't let us touch them. You have no idea people that hate us because of your attitude. Yes. You are right. There are husbands, they just hate the men of God because of the attitude of their wife, because they hide behind the men. Because of lack of knowledge. I told the man, go back to YouTube, select these messages and listen. She came back to me and said, I'm sorry, sir. Now I learned that it's my wife's Miri Subai. I said, never. I told him, I said, I stand for family values. I preach that one more than anything else. I am one of the few prophets who don't prophesy alone, but also divide the word of truth. There are men here struggling. I've seen women walk to me and say, my husband has not touched me for 4 years. Yes, I'm telling you. I'm telling you, 3 years. I've seen it. I don't even know how to counsel them. I don't know how to handle them. I've also seen women that are fighting with their husband on sex. They have accepted the marriage, but they are fighting. My brother, yeah, Juma Bibre, my essay, and my essay, and my essay, because they don't understand the scriptures. And that's what I'm telling you. So for some of the women don't even know the sexual needs of a man.
Yes, sir.
They don't understand it. They don't understand it. I thought that if it's once in a month, I will be fine. That is what you think. But at the end of the Bible, and when you were rushing to come and fix a date and buy those wedding gowns, you didn't read those scriptures. Some of you moon country, you have never read one book of marriage. There are people who have married for 10 years, they've never read one book of marriage. So there is no improvement in the marriage. All the family life after opening Kwajochre, Bishop Benanum, which family life expert do we have in Ghana again? Omunina ye old. Say say Obian can wa send me Obia person ye prophet. No send come no nyakakra. Man must work ministry. So yes, send come on people, but the families are dying. So if God called people in the family life, they are not ready to respond because I was scared. Uncle bought them, they acted movies on it. Only God can tell how many marriages they rescue, but they are growing. Omunina enter our 60s. A big crowd go to 70s. Where are those who take their mantle? A lot of the conference you go, all they do is to catch witches. Break. Oh, I read something that a cat in a cold weather in London, America, they will say that, oh my God, it's so cold. Oh, look at that poor cat. In Europe, they will say, oh my world, she might be feeling cold. If Africa, your cat appeared, die by fire. Die by fire. You black cat that has appeared, die by fire. So if you go to a place and it's not die by fire, it's not it. So you are release all the fire, but your marriage is die. Because when it comes to marriage, it's not die by fire. A successful marriage is based on knowledge.